Thank you very much for coming. Thanks very much for your welcoming words. I'm happy to be here in India for the first time in my life. And that's sort of innovation. You know, you've been invited at 10:45, and now we have 11:07. You can imagine what this means for a German with his efficient thinking and with his urge to be perfect in all aspects of life. So now we are here, and I will spend some time with you giving some information from the wide range of the catalog you just read to the people here. Yes, I'm 60 years old now. That means quite a long time on the earth. And many experiences, many changes in life, many crises, and in the end, still survival. My parents gave me the name of Harry when I was young. You probably see that did not came out really the right way they expected. They could as well call me Hawk's Eye, or Slim and Tall, or whatever, Forever Young. So sometimes you judge differently from reality, and I will give you some insights on what we are doing in the world. We have some big companies on our list, and first of all, we have to find clients to cooperate, who give you the trust to come up to you and say, yes, we believe in you, come on, let's do something together. And for that reason, we have many, many businesses in different parts of the field of training development. Some examples there, I don't want to bore you with this. Big names, of course, I don't want to impress you with this. I must thank our partners as well, because it's a network I stand for. It's globally, and we have the name in one of them, it's Globiana. They're much bigger than Bittner International, and they do services worldwide, multicultural trainings and all that. And they are on the high end of technology. So what they do is really have an app for education. What we do here is the old school, just be face to face. And young people, they have a span of attention of 10 seconds. So if you give them an app, they can learn, like the language app, blah, blah, or Duolingo, or whatever you use there in your country. So we have a switch there as well. And at my age, I have to adapt to the behaviors of my children as well, who say, hey, Dad, you're old-fashioned. You know? So I left away my tie, and I get rid of my mic as well. So body language sometimes disturbs you, but I think you can fix it again. Wonderful. And it's still working, yes. Thanks, you can turn it up again, sounds again. So it's globally, everything is global, and that has changed the world a lot. Coming from a small village, the biggest change for people sometimes is when they move to the next village, where they found the loved person, perhaps, and changed their whole environment and say, that was a big change in my life. Other people, I see the young consultants, they travel from Shanghai to Rio to New York within 1 week. And they say, coming back to these locals, yes, you have to change, you have to adapt, cultural issues. Do you know what's going on in China? There's a threat, they want your job. They have lower prices over there. And you have to adapt to this. And there's the shareholder people as well who say, yeah, money is an issue. We want 6, 17, 25, 180% per year. And so work hard for us, for our purse, that we can afford our big ships or whatever you want to pay for. So that's a big challenge between all these things. How much do you dare to speak out what is reality? How much do you act politically? How much are you creative just to deal with all these challenges in life? That will be part of what we're going to talk through. We have one nice project at the moment running to show you about this. It's Thomas Cook. Some insights, it's a tourist operator with some airlines on board, and they have decided to put a new concept in place that means customer at our heart. And then you come to the hotel people here, who has been in the breakfast this morning, bunches of people running around. I wanted to circle down the way they do and how, what they transport and what the effect of what they're doing is, but I stopped after 5 minutes. It was really confusing. You know, it was like an ants family. They were running here and there, and I could not follow them up anymore. Even with movement tracking, it would be impossible to operate this in a system. But about ants, just a remark. Ants, perhaps you know this, are very often recommended as the example for heavy working people. They can carry 20 times more the weight they have on their own. But on the other side, not everyone knows, 70% of their time, they just chill out at home. So what we see is just the surface, just running around, throwing their rooting, all the things we see in the films. But no one films them at home when they're watching TV or telling stories. So they need this to be that high effective on the other end. And what we did here is we made a promise via the internet platforms like TripAdvisor and Hotel Check or whatever you have. You need an 85% recommendation rate minimum. Otherwise, you're not content, or you will drop to 70 and then you're out of the game. And we want to go up to 90%. How can you do this? You make promises to your customers. That's from the marketing side. You say, within 24 hours, we have all things repaired. You get your money back or whatever we can offer you. But the people on the front desk or the people on the housekeeping, they're not aware of this promise. They are bad paid. They have just to survive somehow in the business they are, in the housekeeping or F&B business, in the cooking. You know these people. They're really working hard to just survive and fill the fridge at home. And now, how can you reach these people? How can you encourage them just to do something in favor of others? What I found out with the Indian culture is high developed self-sacrifice behind this. It's good for your karma if you do something good for other people. In Germany, it's more the numbers on your bank account. The car you have, it's very important in Germany. How big is your car? Is it bigger and the latest model? The best brand, or is just the second brand you have there? So if you come up there with a BMW, you're fine. If you have a Volkswagen or General Motors, it depends on the size and on the horsepower you have there, and perhaps on the sound system you include. So we have all big competition, Audi, BMW, Porsche, who come to the market, and then it's really impressive how people buy and how they get up. And to find out what the client wants is a part of our training program as well. You don't qualify only people with putting knowledge in them. That's one part of it. But we see the whole system. How can we make it work from the top management down to the reception boy? And that's really hard to do. It takes years and years just to change the attitude. And I'll give you some insights how we do this with the heart. You know, the symbol. We have the Valentine's Day. It was yesterday, and I heard there's a Valentine's week even. You start with the Rose Day, just to come back to the Hug Day, and then the Kiss Day is the final Valentine. So why not have 365 Valentines? And love what you do, and love the people you're with, and do it with enthusiasm. It really comes back to you as a power, you probably know. You have to integrate the intellectual aspects as well, the knowledge, but you have to do it with heart, to be enthusiastic, motivated, and to incite other people as well, so they can follow you. If you do this, people believe you and you're credible. If not, it's just a show. Perhaps I can give you some insights in German politicians. You know, that's the German Chancellor, Mrs. Merkel. She has a body language trainer who told her just to make the heart here. Before her body, and she's overdoing it a little bit. People are only looking at her bullshit body language at the moment, not really on what she talks and what she does. And you probably heard about the migrant problem, the immigrants in Germany. That's really a big bunch of change we have there at the moment. And she's pushing it against all odds. And she's succeeding on one hand, and she's getting lots of critics. And that is what innovation is. You have to be creative, find solutions, and then you take the risk to put this into the life. And there's so many people who say that's wrong because you're wrong because you did this the wrong way. And that is really a hard thing to stand. You can become separate someday. So what you all know is from innovation, the toolbox. You probably know the TRIS, probably know the brainstorming, and all the other systems, and these systems are installed by wonderful consultants who convince you or your decision makers, just buy me, I'm great. I bring out the best of the people within seconds, at the wink of the eye. That's the promise. And sometimes it works. And it works if you take one toolbox there, it's a creatrix, and this says there's one exercise, it's called the great bar. You give everyone a pencil, a flip sharp, paper, whatever you have, but you do not allow people to speak. And that's a huge change. They only talk to each other, they get in contact to each other, they see each other, they are aware of what's going on, and they have a written discussion, even being present. It's much more interesting than a telco or a video conference. Oh yeah, thank you. Mm-hmm. Yeah, there are many more instruments down there. Blue seas and reverse thinking and synergy. So all this is working, depends, but it does not always make people happy or you have all these reactions to stand. Some are better than others, some are really enthusiastic. This is the greatest thing, I've been to the conference, you have to read this book. That is what people seem to exchange as an opinion, and they come from their own experience base. So then invite these people who are enthusiastic, just come on in, let's try out something new. Say, no, I'm so well with my instrument, I don't want to touch this, it's a well-running system. And for that reason, companies like Nokia went bankrupt, because even at the look down to the end of the company, they said, we did not make any mistake. We did right. So if you're convinced you're right, you're already a little piece of idiot inside. If you're not open for what else is in the world going on, and then you suddenly vanish, you brush away from the marketplace. So what I told you about is emotions as well. This is a survey people in Finland made. So what is emotion doing with your body? You can kill yourself within a short period of time not being emotional, just holding back your emotions. And you can see it from the blue color. That means controlled, not really interfering with your bacteria and your cells, just being stiff like this will make you die earlier. A thing we know all about what's going on if you're not within your energy flow and you're holding back your forces. There's nothing going on in your brain anymore. And there's one technology, it's called HeartMath, that gives you an insight what is going on in your system. If the heart is communicating with the brain, the two halves of the brain and the amygdala, they will combine, and then you have a transmitter system that really brings out new things. You can do meditation as well. You can run and have the runner's high. All this is very good for your system in general. Or you are only limited to having decision-making things, having the best arguments, and that's only a part of it. So this is my introduction. This is the result of innovation in a proper way and positively. You get 11 years older on average. Some people love to die earlier because the life is so hard. But if you really love life, then 11 years is something impressive. I'm 60 now, and I have planned to have another 25 years just working. And then we see what's going on. So what is Creatrix about? Creatrix is the name of the Egyptian goddess of creativity. And the founder of this name, or the instrument, was Richard Bird. He used to be a priest living in New York, and from there he moved to the industry as a consultant and took all the knowledge from work in the Christian community to companies. And then his daughter, who is 65, Jacqueline, in Minneapolis, Twin Cities, she developed this at the university. They made more research, and over 100,000 people went through this instrument already. And there are big companies between, Germans, American companies like 3M. You probably know them, very innovative. They just, they prohibited PowerPoint presentations in their meetings. Can you imagine this? Stop all this. Just go interact with people and you get a result because it's people business. We changed from B2B or B2C to human, H2H. And that is the most important thing. everyone counts, as we said with Ford. Every personality has an impact on what's going on. And if the system is not running well, one can be the reason for this. So it's like a team. You have to play together, and if one is not doing his duties, then you will probably lose in the end. We coming from a soccer nation, Germany, we know this, that team play can be helpful for world championship. So we have two aspects, or let's two factors. One is creativity. That means create ideas. You all know about this. The other thing is risk-taking, and this together makes your power counting. How high is your innovation capacity? And my belief so far, my experience is in every person there is a high capacity, unless you have untrained it. People do not allow it to you. You have not the right culture. And for that reason, people with high innovation capacity, they leave the companies. And we have several universities that said, all the good people are gone. Then look at the professor. Then you can imagine why they leave. The same with the companies. We make a survey and find out all the innovators are in the marketing, in the sales, in the development department, R&B. And then the boss said, no, this is a nuisance, a bad idea. There's a picture about this. It's coming with an idea like a candlelight. And the boss said, we don't need it. So you're frustrated, you go into protest mode, and leave the company. That's normally what we experience there. So this is the place where we come now to counting. It's an online tool. You can ask, answer 35 questions. It's quite cheap. I think it's around 100 US dollars. And you get a place in this continuum. And the first place is when you face change or innovation, you just sustain where you are. In case of emergency, just duck and cover. You know this. And to reach these people, to bring oxygen to this place, is one of the roles for training or coaching process, just to bring people on board again. Otherwise, they are lost. Then we have the other one, that is the higher percentage, people who modified a little bit, yes, adapt a little bit. When we used to introduce laptops in the sales force from Dr. Oetker, it's a nutrition company like Nestle, they produce pizza worldwide and other products, people didn't want to use it. And in the training, they shared one laptop and said, can I use your A, please? Can you imagine this? People sitting next to each other and wanted to share the alphabet. So they didn't know that they had to use it in future with all the alphabets. And other people, they tricked the company and said, yes, I make my notes at home and my wife puts in all the data when I arrive at home. So I had an extra hour work. And to overcome these habits, bad habits, I would say, that is part to do this. So modifier is a very good thing, but it does not bring the big effect. What else do we have? The challenger up there. You have, in India, holy cows. You probably know them. These people give, they don't really appreciate what they see. These people, they kill holy cows, you could say. And they just appear there. Perhaps you could compare it with Donald Trump a little bit. He's challenging the system from his point of view, but he has not really own ideas, just picking up ideas from others. So he's not really creative. But he's pushing through with all the power he has, and he just kills everyone who's in the way. That is quite an easy way to get rid of people that are creative. Then you have the planning people, project management people who make a plan for everything. Let's plan first before we execute. You need them as well. Every project management tool needs planning inside. But these people are so occupied with planning that they have not enough power for executing anymore. They will not take the risk. Then we have the real good people, I would say. You need them in every company who make things possible. They are balancing, they are risk takers, and they are executing things, and they bring results to the company. This is the core of it. High risk, but result-orientated. And then you have the synthesizer people there who bring things together. Many HR people are in the synthesizing mode. They have people here, they have a department there, they have different cultures, and they have to integrate them. And then we have the outside, the dreamer. It's below 1% or 1% in average. This person, they are very rare. They can think of a wonderful future. They're able, they have the capacity just to think how future might be like. But if you ask them, come on, good idea, let's do it, they say, no, step back. It was just an idea. I don't dare. And then you have the innovators. They have an idea every second, new ideas, big ideas, and they are willing to push through and really to fight for what they think is a good idea. And if you don't give them the space, they disappear, go to the competition, or build up their own family business, which is their solution, just an exit strategy. If I don't have the right environment for my ideas, I just leave, no problem. High risk, high ideas, I see the market, I see many good companies, many options, and with these options, I just have more choices. So that's the overview of the map, and you get a map for a company, and you can say the percentages, an average, the whole database worldwide is this. This is how they share it. And there are some people you can exchange easily. The modifier with 37% is something you can replace easily. But the innovators and the dreamers are really a rare species. So this is a result of a group of ladies within the Mentium group. And this group is just scattered around. You get a result for this. And depending on the boss, you get a culture of development or not. That is what you can get there. Now I will give you some advice how you go through the system. And this will be some Pecha Kucha to finalize this. You probably know the system. Many pictures in a short time to give you an awareness what's going on there. And I will start with how can we make the drivers move? That means speed up the process. And we go into the creativity drivers. Four of them are there. You can read. I don't want to repeat them. But I will give you the insight what's behind this. So ambiguity. You don't know really what's going on. You're not sure what to do. It's not black and white. It's not sure. It's insecure. In language, you have many possibilities to interpret things. You probably know this. The same word means different things. And the tolerance for ambiguity is very interesting. We had it at the beginning of the session. Huh? Wanted to start punctually, but someone said, no, don't do it. Shall we? So just, okay, you can be relaxed. Just, it's going like it's going. Don't get stressed. We have the other thing that you should be independent from others, not be the average. One thing, you should play your own game. You should be independent in all aspects. Probably know this from India. You celebrate independence every year, and you probably know what belonging to the big empire means. Perhaps you're not killed, perhaps you're not prosecuted, not in jail, but it's worth it to fight for something. You believe it's a good thing. I have the example of John Lennon at school. They told him, what do you want to be? And he said, I will be happy. And the teacher said, oh, you're completely wrong. You misunderstood the question. And he said, yes, you understood life, misunderstood life. That was his conclusion from this. So this inner-directed or auto-directed, you're a good consumer if you're auto-directed and buy what people tell you on the TV or in the cinema movies, buy this, buy that, that's good for you. I recommend you to do this, or you have your own impulse from the inside. That is the difference from consumer side, inner or outer directed as well. Now we come to uniqueness, something, you know, I wear a gray suit, which is really fashionable at the moment. If I look around, gray suits, okay, you're, for German aspects, you're fine. No tie in German is okay. The boss of Daimler-Benz at the Paris Motor Show came up without tie. Silicon Valley just throw away the ties. So people who were really in a revolution mode, they put on ties again now. So they react on this, just playing with it a little bit to make things different. So appreciate differences in people, in food, in behavior. That's diversity, and you're on the right track. You know this probably. Some people overdoing this, the individual thing. Perhaps their self-confidence is not highly developed enough, so they become a picture or a tattoo landscape. So now we come to risk-taking. And I will ask you, what was the highest risk you took in your life? And when did you really take risk last time? What was it? Just imagine. As a child, you probably fall down and get up. You have some marks everywhere, some injuries. But some people forget about this when they get established. Or they have the salary, they have the security of a big company, or they have some expectations, their family, house, all this is really not inviting to take risk. But that means you lose your risk gene a little bit. And if you stay like a child, you probably know what it's like. They tell you the truth. Hey, Daddy, what's wrong with your belly? Yes. No, I'm fine. Okay, let's do some sports. Or fall down and get up again, resiliency. And the last thing is love yourself for what you are. Brené Brown is one of my admired examples for showing vulnerability, and she says, yes, if you want to be authentic, be yourself. Be what you are. Don't pretend to be something else. Concrete is much better in, to some aspects, if you think of resiliency, but the cockroach can even stand a nuclear bomb, so this is quite a better way of resiliency. So that's how it works in the company. You know all these aspects probably from many books, from the universities, but it's so complex. It starts with yourself. And how you look on yourself is one thing. Do you accept yourself how you are? Even if you have a strange nose, can you integrate this into your life? Are you proud of what you are, how you look like? This is an advertisement of a company who sells beauty products. So yes, you are okay like you are. And you know this as well. Does not count what others think of you, what you think of you. So carry on and don't do things you did all the time if you want to innovate. I can just encourage you just to do one thing a day. And this is the list for the drivers that support the drivers. Just start with one thing. Pick one for yourself, even what make photos. Just listen to your own ideas and list 5 new ideas every day for a week, and you will get innovative, perhaps. If you're inner direct, you listen to your inner voice. And if you bring it to the place, look for the good in the situations, you either win or learn. So easy going. So this is my family, here my boys, my wife, and I must tell you I have an anniversary as well. We have 25 years of marriage, and my beautiful wife is sitting over there, and she is supporting me all the time. Thanks a lot, Martina, and thanks a lot for everyone for coming. I wish you all the best you have there from whatever religion you are. It was a pleasure for me to have you here. If you have more questions, just get in contact. Just next to the camera. Please get up, Martina. Ah, a beautiful blonde and a big heart, and we are connected not only via voice. Thanks a lot for your attention. I wish you a good innovation standard, good capacity, and if God will, we see us again in other place and in good condition, on the next life, as he would say in India. Yeah, one question, okay. Where is it?
Most people, you have the innovator right on the top right corner.
Yeah.
But would it be fair to say that they are the most disliked in any organization?
Yes, you could say the innovators are hated from some, admired from others, and destroyed from others as well. So you have to stand all the fire if you're there. And you have to be convinced that you're on the right way. So inner directed. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Second question. Pardon? I think the slides are on the database because I will leave them here and you can download them. That's my knowledge. So if you look on the HRD homepage, you can get them. Yes. Thanks a lot. With your help, I was finishing right time. Thanks. Have a good Congress together. Thank you.